Carl Oscar Lawaczeck, you are the CEO of OceanSky. Right now, you are selling your first tickets to some really old but still new way of flying. Can you tell us more about this?
That's correct. We're releasing tickets for a North Pole journey, an expedition to the North Pole, in the largest flying vehicle in the world. It's called the Airlander 10, and it's a hybrid aircraft or an airship of historic proportions. It's the largest in the world, really. And what's unique about this trip is that it's the first ever airship to ever land on the North Pole. And tickets are for 2023, the season of 2023.
And tell us more about this aircraft.
It's a lighter than air technology vehicle. So it's called a hybrid aircraft, because it operates not only by lifting gas, so it operates also with aerodynamic lift and also engine thrust that you can divert thrust downwards and backwards. It's almost 100 meters long. It flew for the first time in 2012, then under a military development regime. So it's almost 7 years ago, or 7 years ago, and it started to fly under civilian regulation in 2016 for the first time. And OceanSky started working together with this manufacturer that is in England, north of London, in 2013 to develop a concept to bring large-scale, modern airships or lighter than air technology vehicles to commercial aviation.
Do you think this is something that really can compete with the traditional flying in the future?
Compete, yes. Compete and also become an alternative to. It has its place somewhere along with road travel or rail travel or conventional aviation. It is a more comfortable way of traveling, so it's more like a flying boat or a flying hotel. It's slower, obviously, but in terms of time efficiency, it flies direct and it flies point to point, so it doesn't need airports. So you don't need to pave runways, which actually can make your travel less time consuming, and you can also do something with your time, not just sit in a chair. You can actually walk around, and you can work, and you can eat, and you can look out the windows in a completely different way.
But how much would this cost? Is it for everyone, or is it really expensive?
So the first tickets are very expensive, or the first itineraries are very expensive, because there's lots of design costs to offset, obviously, and development costs. So one ticket is 600,000 crowns, which is about $64,000. And that is for one cabin that holds two people. So you can really say per person it's only 300,000 crowns. But this is the first tickets we release, and then the ticket price might not stay there. It might actually go up because it's very limited.
So what are your visions for the future?
The visions is then to penetrate mass market applications. So first we show what this technology can do. It can take huge loads, it can fly very far, it can land without airports, right? When we have shown that, the next segments are passenger transport, like you're used to going to Munich and just to actually transport yourself there. But it also continue in travel and high-end experiences, but also then in cargo and what we call the specialized cargo applications for cargo that is going to remote places, etc.